Good morning. I am so glad you're here. This is going to be not only a special and very different chapel, but it's going to be a blessing as well. So for those of you that may be wondering what today's going to be like, a few years ago we wanted to do a kind of a worship service on a Monday morning. We do it quite a bit at gatherings on Tuesday evenings in years past. But we wanted to do something like that on a Monday morning. So that's what we're going to be doing today. I'll tell you a little bit more about it in just a minute. As you saw on the slide right before we started, there is going to be some wonderful opportunities for you to do kind of a gathering-like experience in the quad. It will start tomorrow night. So get there early so you can be sure to be a part of the experience there on the lawn of the quad. It'll start at 7 p.m., and we're really thrilled about this opportunity. The following week, we'll start a Bible study in the book of Philippians over in the church, and so we'll kind of go back and forth between a worship experience in the quad and a Bible study in the church building. So we're trying to think of ways to give you opportunities not only to be together, but spend time with God and hear from His Word and participate in chapel. Something else that's brand new, you're going to see these QR codes around campus. For those of you that would love to be a part of praying for others, or if you have a prayer request that you would like to share with our prayer team or our prayer ministry, you'll just take a picture of this QR code, and a little event sheet or a prayer request form will pop up on your phone. You can submit it, and that prayer team will be praying for your special request. So you're going to see these QR codes all around campus in the next week or so, and the prayer team is really excited about coming alongside of you to pray for special things that are on your heart as they come and go throughout your life during this semester. Our speaker next week is John Demeter from Redemption Peoria. John has been a speaker here in chapel and at the gathering in years past, and so we're bringing him back, and he'll be here next Monday morning. And if you've never heard John, he's a wonderful communicator. He has a background with Athletes in Action, has been on college campuses for years and years, and just a wonderful brother who communicates with great passion from the Word of God. Today, our chapel leader is Kristen Moore, and I'm going to read a little bit about him. If you don't know Kristen, he is the worship pastor of North Phoenix Baptist Church, and this is what it says. Yeah, there you go. He's a native of Bakersfield, California, and the ninth child to a musically gifted family of 10. Wow. Kristen began playing piano and singing at the age of 4. Later in life, doors began to open for him as a musical director and minister of music for his local church. He found himself accompanying a multitude of recording artists and also becoming a member of the group Israel Houghton and New Breed, traveling all over the world spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ through song. Kristen has now come full circle in fulfilling his first passion, bringing hope and love to the world through music. He has been married to the love of his life, Kelsey, for 4 years, and they welcomed their firstborn son, Jacob, in the summer of 2020. Yay. Congratulations, husband and daddy. So we're glad to have you, Kristen. Enjoy today. Would you stand to your feet? We're going to read from Psalm 100 to open our service this morning, and it says this. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us, and we are His. We are His people, the sheep of His pasture. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His courts with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name. For the Lord is good, and His love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. May God bless the reading of His Word.
How we doing this morning, GCU? So how we doing this morning, GCU? Can we clap our hands? Can we just shout unto God with the voice of triumph this morning? Listen, I don't know about you guys, but I'm totally excited to be here. I know this is a new look, something different. It's real stripped down. But I want to worship with you guys this morning, something that's been on my heart, specifically about the word sound. I was reading in Genesis, you know, all throughout Scripture, we find out that sound changes atmospheres, and atmospheres have to respond to sound. What do I mean by that? Genesis 1, God said he created the heavens and the earth. He spoke, and the atmosphere had to respond to his voice, the sound of his voice. And another verse, David, one of my favorite characters in the Bible, when Saul had a spirit that was really just depriving him, they called on David to play the lyre, to play the harp. The moment he played, the sound that came out of that harp was able to change his atmosphere. And even the children of Israel, when they walked around the city of Jericho, and when they marched around, I'm pretty sure we all know that story, and they lifted up a shout, the atmosphere of Jericho had to respond to the sound. And so for me, being here this morning with you, I'm totally excited because I believe that there's a sound that God is looking for this morning. I believe that God is looking for a sound to come from his people, specifically his students all over GCU this morning, that will lift up a sound of worship where people are able to walk by if they're not even in here, and they'll be able to say, what must I do to know the God that they're serving? What must I do to get to know the Jesus that they're lifting up name on high? So I'm going to ask you all to do something. Can you all lift your hands all over the room as a sign of surrender unto our God? This is something that I love to do everywhere that I go. Can we just lift up our hands? And for just a few moments, I'm going to even ask you to close your eyes for a second. I want you to just begin to speak to God. Why don't you tell God what you're thinking this morning? What's on your mind this morning? Seconds. Come on, just lift up the name of the Lord.
He's a wonder in my soul. Nobody like our God. He's great. He does miracles so great. There's nobody like our God. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns forever all my days.
Help me lift that up, GCU. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, our God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, our God.
Yeah. Come on, hallelujah is the highest praise we can give him. So, hallelujah,
our God reigns.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, our God reigns.
So, hallelujah,
our God reigns.
Forever. Let's just stay right there a little bit longer. Say hallelujah,
hallelujah, our God reigns.
Come on, lift it up, GCU, hallelujah. Time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
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 Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Would you help me lift this up, you guys?
You give life, you are love, you bring. You give,
yeah.
You reach every. Great are you, Lord.
Let's lift it up together. Say,
it's your breath.
Say,
in our.
Yeah. Sing the verse one more time. Help me out, you guys. Come on.
You give life. You are love.
You bring light to the darkness.
You bring light to
what a mighty God we serve.
Darkness.
You bring hope.
You give hope.
You restore.
You restore
every heart that is broken.
Every heart that is broken.
Great are you, Lord.
Great are you.
Beginning to pour out your praise unto your Lord. Why don't you lift up a sound of worship in the room? Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Come on, let me hear you this morning. God wants to hear from you, not just me. God wants to hear from you. Come on, let him hear you.
Hey. So all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing.
Yeah.
risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Can you help me lift that up? It just says he is Lord.
He is Lord. Say he is Lord. He is Lord.
He has risen from.
He has risen from the dead. And he is Lord. Every knee shall. So I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise, treasures that fade, are never enough. Then you came along.
We're talking about the King of Kings.
And put me back together. Is now satisfied here in your love. Oh, there's nothing say
better than you. There's nothing
say
better than you. There's nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing is better than you.
Can you shout right there if you know that there's nothing better than your God? Your Savior, your King. So I'm not afraid. Say,
I'm not afraid
to show you my weakness.
To show you my weakness.
My failures and flaws.
My failures and flaws.
Lord, you see them
all. Lord, you've seen them all, and you still call me friend.
I love this verse. It says, "'Cause the God of the mountain."
Cause the God of the mountain.
Better than
you. There's nothing
better than. taste and see that the Lord is good, you know for sure there's nothing. Oh,
there's nothing.
Nothing. Say it. Think about what it is saying. Oh, there's, Lord, there's nothing. Nobody greater than you.
by the cleansing blood of Jesus Christ. That's something to shout about right there. You've been washed by the cleansing blood of Jesus Christ. He overlooked your faults. He overlooked my faults. And he saw every need. We serve such a rich and an amazing and a powerful God. Not just because he gives us what we want, but he really gives us what we need. God is so faithful. Can anybody attest for his faithfulness in this room? In the midst of a pandemic, you know the thing I love about this chapel? In the midst of a pandemic, you have 1,000 students who are lifting up their voice and lifting up their hands to give God praise. That's so magnificent to me. It's so amazing. We're just going to keep lifting up the name of Jesus. Is that all right? We're going to sing a couple of more worship songs. We're going to teach you a song, if that's all right. You can turn this mic down a little bit. That's what it is. I want you to just repeat this after me. Our God,
he's champion. He reigns forevermore.
down into dark.
is great.
Such a sweet spirit in this room. Such a sweet spirit. We got one more song we're going to sing, but before I even explain that song, I just want to sing this part. Out of pain, it was birthed out of sorrow. I was attending a church and the first lady had passed away of cancer, and I was very close to the family, still am close to the family. And saying goodbye, as you all know, it's never easy. And truth of the matter is, you never really get over it. You just try every day to get over it. After the funeral, after the flowers stop, after the cards stop, it's you. And of course, God. So God gave me this song, and I believe it comforted me. But after last year experiencing so many tragic deaths, and even this year, some of you have probably experienced death in your families. Whether it was last year, whether it was 5 years ago, whether that was 10 years ago, there's still a stinging in the heart. So when I wrote this song, all I said was,
sometimes I wish I could see you again, just for a while to say goodbye. But I'm happy for you, 'cause you made it to God's throne room. No more hurt, no more pain, only a smile on your face. I know weeping endures for a night, and joy does come in the morning. I know this is true, but your death came out the blue, so my heart's still heavy. I just wasn't ready to say goodbye.
Hope this song brings somebody comfort.
This year has opened my eyes. I've seen death, I've seen smiles, even heartache for a while. For those who were dearest to me that left here so early, I never said goodbye. I know weeping endures for a night, and joy does come in the morning. I know this is true, but your death came out the blue,
So my heart's still heavy. I just wasn't ready. Sometimes I wish I could see you again, just for a while to say goodbye. But I'm happy for you,
'cause you made it to God's throne room.
No more hurt, no more pain, only a smile on your face. I know weeping endures for a night, and joy does come in the morning. I know this is true, but your death came out the blue. So my heart's still heavy. I just wasn't ready to say goodbye. 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 If I had just one more chance, this one thing I would say is, hey, goodbye. Goodbye. I just wasn't ready. Hey, goodbye. Goodbye. I just wasn't ready. Say,
heaven is open.
Heaven is open.
And it's waiting for you.
With tears in my eyes, I'm waving goodbye.
Heaven is open.
But heaven is open.
And it's waiting for you.
And it's waiting for
you.
I just wasn't ready.
Heaven is open.
And it's waiting.
Heaven is open.
You're still in my heart. And it's waiting for
you.
I just wasn't ready. Sometimes I wish I could see you again, just for a while to say goodbye. But I'm happy for you, 'cause you made it to God's throne room. No more hurt, no more pain, only a smile on your face. I know weeping endures for a night, and joy does come in the morning. I know this is true, but your death came out the blue. So my heart's still heavy. I just wasn't ready to say goodbye. Thank you. So my hope and prayer for you all as we close our chapel today, that not only that you'll be comforted by that song, but every single worship song that we sung today, I was about to say tonight, that it will comfort your spirit, that it will sing to your soul. When you're in the dark trenches of the hour, these words will speak life to you. I wanted to close with "It Is Well" before I sung "I Just Wasn't Ready." Because when you get to that posture of "It Is Well with My Soul," there's absolutely nothing you can do. There's nothing that can stop you. It is well with my soul. Can we all lift our hands? So God, as we come to you, as we close out this chapel, God, we want to thank you for being such an on-time, an amazing, a perfect, consistent God. God, there's many students in here right now, God, who are probably going through a hard time. Some are probably dealing with things that nobody knows about. I'm asking that you would meet them in that place. God, that you would minister to their soul, that you would minister to their hearts. With our hands lifted high, God, as high as they can go, as a sign of surrender, God, I'm asking that you would teach us how to take our hands off of things and allow you to take full control of our lives. God, I'm asking, Lord Jesus, God, that you would prepare our hearts and that you would teach us, Lord, how to dive deeper into you. God, as much as you are a consistent God to us, I'm asking, Lord Jesus, God, on behalf of everybody in here, including myself, that we would be more consistent to you. God, I thank you for what you've done even right now in this chapel, how you've ministered to the souls, how you've ministered to the hearts, how you've ministered to this amazing team. And God, we thank you for what you're doing at Grand Canyon University. What an amazing, amazing time this was today. So God, we love you, and as we leave, we ask that we never leave your presence. And it's in your precious Son, Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You all are dismissed. Thank you so much. God bless.